Ever wondered how robots balance or how your phone knows when you tilt it? It's all thanks to sensors like the MPU6050, a motion sensor that can detect movement and orientation. In this video, I'll show you how the MPU6050 works. We'll read live data from it using the serial monitor, and then we'll build a simple project to control LEDs based on tilt. So let's get started. The MPU6050 is a 6-axis sensor with a 3-axis accelerometer and a 3-axis gyroscope. The accelerometer tells us the direction of gravity and motion, and the gyroscope measures how fast the sensor is rotating. With these two sensors, we can calculate angles like pitch and roll, which tell us how much the device is tilted forward, backward, or left and right.
Now let's make the circuit. So I have an ESP32 settled on the breadboard and the sensor, and also some jumper wires. So first I set the sensor to the breadboard, and then I make the power connections. So the VCC of the sensor I connect to 5 volts on ESP32, then the ground. Now lastly, we'll make the I2C communication connections, so the SDA and SCL. The SCL I connect to pin 22 on ESP32, and the SDA to the pin 21. Yeah. So that's all about the circuit. Now let's move on to the code. In addition, you can use Arduino Uno instead of ESP32. So there are already SDA and SCL pins. There is no need to connect to any of the analog pin like on ESP32. And there is no need to define them in the code. I'll also share the codes for those which will use Arduino Uno.
Now onto the code site. I launched the Arduino IDE, and first of all, I go to Library Manager and write here MPU6050. And then download the latest version of this library and include it on your code. So go to the sketch, include library. MPU6050. So this library makes it easier to communicate with the sensor. It wraps a lot of lower level communication, so I don't have to manually access every register of the MPU6050. It comes with functions like initialize and get motion, which are very beginner friendly. Then I include another library, which is already installed on the Arduino IDE wire. And this library enables the I2C communication, which is how the ESP32 talks to the sensor. For those who don't know, I2C is a two-wire protocol using SDA and SCL lines, which we worked with in the circuit. So this library gives me the functions needed to initialize the bus and read-write data to the sensor. Now here I create an object called MPU, which will represent the physical sensor, MPU. Okay. Then in the void setup function, we'll begin the serial communication, the I2C communication between ESP32 and the sensor, and also initialize the MPU6050. Serial.begin, parenthesis, 115,200. Semicolon. Now wire dot begin, parenthesis, and first rewrite the SDA, which is on the pin 21, comma the SCL, so pin 22. Now initialize the sensor. Now I'll just serial prints in the monitor to make sure if the MPU is initialized. Quotation marks. MDO initialized. All right, that's it all for void setup. Now move to void loop. First, I'll create 60 variables to store the raw values coming from the accelerometer and the gyro. So int 16 underline t ax, so accelerometer x axis, a y, a z, gx, jy, and now I'll write the line of code where we actually read the sensor data. So mpu.getMotion, this is a function that comes with the library which we installed at the beginning, and sign ax comma so all of them. Okay, so these three, acceleration and this angular velocity. Now I'll start printing, so you'll print parentheses, string acceleration, oops. So here is where we start to print the values of acceleration. Alright, so these values change when I tilt the sensor or shake it. If I place it flat and still, AZ will be close to 16,384, which is gravity, while X and Y are close to zero. Now let's print the gyro values. So these values tell me how fast the sensor is rotating around each axis. For example, if I rotate the sensor clockwise around its Z axis, this variable will go positive. And I also add a delay at the end of a half second, so it keeps the output from spamming the serial monitor too fast. And now compile the sketch if there are errors. Alright, we are clean. Now let's upload the code and test it. Alright, so I uploaded the code. So my... oh, what? Not connected. So, as you see, guys, on the serial monitor, I tilt right, the acceleration values change. Now I tilt left, it changes as well. Now up. And down. I guess I know why it disconnects spontaneously. Because of this rubbish cable.
Alright guys, so now let's make a circuit for demonstration. So I have three LEDs right here. And based on the acceleration value, they'll turn on and off. So for example, when I tilt left the sensor, the red LED will turn on. Then when I tilt right, the green one, and back forward, blue one. So let's make it quickly. First, I set the LEDs to the breadboard. Okay. Or I have another idea. I'll power this line with the ground and connect the LEDs directly to that. So the LED's ground terminal. Okay. Now I connect the red LED with pin 14 on ESP32. The green one with GPIO27. And lastly, the blue one to 26. And we are all done. Now let's make the code and then test it.
Now in the loop function, before the checking the tilt, I'll make sure all the LEDs are turned off. So right here, I'll turn off all LEDs at the beginning. So red LEDs, comma, low. Okay. And now here's the main point. Now with the if conditions, we'll check to which side is the sensor tilted using the acceleration. So if parenthesis AX is less than 5,000. Oh, wait. Okay. Digital write. Oops. Red LED, comma, high. Semicolon. And now contrary, else if AX is more than 5,000, which means we tilt to right, digital right, green LED. Okay, so in brief, if the x-axis acceleration is less than minus 5,000, it means the sensor is tilted to the left. So I turn on the red LED. And if it's more than 5,000, it's tilted to the right. So I turn on the green LED. And now we are at the y-axis. So if it goes above 5,000 or below minus 5,000, that means the sensor is tilted either forward or backward. In both cases, we'll turn on the blue LED. So if AY is above 5,000 or AY is below minus 5,000, then digital right, blue LED. Then here comes the delay, and it repeats again by turning off all the LEDs right here, then checking again the data from sensor and repeating the same process. And now I verify the code if there is anything wrong or any error. And okay, now I can send the code. Alright guys, I uploaded the code and right now I'm testing. It works, I guess. Why I'm saying I guess, because I don't have any idea how it works. I tilted left. So first of all, when it's down, the green one turns on. Then when I tilt up, it turns off. The red one, I'll tilt left, it turns off, and right, it tilts on. And the blue one doesn't work neither. What is the mystery here? I have mistakenly connected this ground line on the breadboard where the LED ground pins are connected to. I've connected to 3.3 volts on ESP32. On the other hand, what a coincidence, I have connected this red light's positive side to the ground. So it actually is connected to 3.3 volts and on the other side to the pin, which behaves based on the MPU's data. I don't know how it works, but it works. Yeah, some engineering problems. Look. So as you see, the longest pin is on the 3.3 volts,
and the other one on the pin. I don't know how it works, but yeah, it works. It doesn't matter neither. Yeah, I've learned how to work with this sensor, so never mind. But if you have any idea to solve it, you can drop in the comments.
And that's it for this video, guys. I hope you find it helpful. And if you have any questions or any critiques, just drop in the comments. Stay tuned and see you in the next video.